There's been a lot of discussion about the iPhone going portless due to the sheer amount of leaks that we've been recently seeing, like from the very reliable Mark Gurman, who says that Apple is already testing some 2021 iPhone models with no charging port. So it's kind of shocking to see more and more rumors showing that we could actually get a portless iPhone as soon as this year. Now, while that's pretty exciting, I personally think that the world is not ready for a completely portless iPhone. Ditching the port would mean that people would have to rely solely on wireless charging to charge their iPhones. This would also mean that Apple would have to throw in their very expensive $39 MagSafe charger into each and every iPhone box. And it's just a bit hard to believe that they're gonna do this. And on top of that, there are many people who buy very thick third-party iPhone cases that might not work that well with wireless charging. So for those reasons and more, I'd honestly have to say that it's just a bit too early to go fully wireless. However, I have a totally wild and crazy theory about the portless iPhone and what portless actually means. And if this turns out to be true, you guys are gonna be totally blown away by how good of an idea this truly is for Apple. My theory is that the portless iPhone isn't gonna be completely portless. It's actually gonna come with a flush magnetic connector in place of the current Lightning port. And it's gonna look extremely similar to Apple's current smart connector on the iPad Pro. This was actually discussed many months ago, but I'm gonna be taking this idea much further and explaining why it makes sense. The idea started blowing up in my head just a few days ago when we got some very important leaks and rumors from Mark Gurman and Ming-Hsun Kuo, who are both very well-respected Apple analysts. They both claimed that Apple was bringing back MagSafe charging to the MacBook lineup. If you're not familiar with that, MagSafe was basically a charging cable that attached magnetically to the side of a MacBook, with the main benefit of the cable easily disconnecting in case somebody tripped over it. There were a couple of issues with it though, like the pins being exposed, with the possibility of them getting damaged. And on top of that, because the MagSafe port was recessed into the MacBook itself, it could get clogged up with dust and potentially metal pieces like staples and other debris, and that would lead to reliability issues. So I think that if Apple is planning to bring MagSafe back to the Mac, it's gonna be completely different with a new modern design. And that makes sense, since the entire MacBook is supposed to get a brand new redesign. And to me, it makes sense for the new MagSafe connector to be either completely flush or almost flush with the body so that no dust can clog or block the pins. Don't worry, you'll still be able to charge it with the USB-C ports, but the new MagSafe cable will be the one that you get in the box because it's just so much more convenient and safe. Now to me, it makes sense for Apple to also bring this same new MagSafe connector to the iPhone as well. And if you think about it, this would actually explain why Apple went back to the completely flat side iPhone design. The flat bottom means that you can now use a completely flush magnetic connector for charging, similar to the smart connector from the iPad. So if both the MacBook and iPhone use the same MagSafe connector, Apple can basically create the same USB-C to MagSafe cables for both of them. So a long version would be going into the MacBook box and a shorter version would go into the iPhone box. This makes a whole lot of sense because if they went completely portless, they would absolutely have to throw in a much more expensive MagSafe charger into the box of every iPhone, and that large charger takes up much more space. But with the new MagSafe cable, it would be as easy as swapping out the Lightning connector for the new MagSafe version, and that would be a much more cost-effective solution for Apple. With that, people would have the choice of using the wired version of MagSafe or the slower wireless version if they want to pay extra to buy one of those MagSafe chargers. And just in case you think this is all pure speculation on my part, we've actually seen some leaks and rumors regarding a smart connector coming to the iPhone. Almost a full year ago, Fudge on Twitter has said multiple times that the iPhone 13 is getting a smart connector. He even said it would be similar to the iPad, and that 2021 iPhones and onward would be getting them. We even saw a similar leak from John Prosser, saying that a smart connector will be used for charging on a portless iPhone. But even better than those leaks are actual patents granted to Apple years ago that basically show Apple experimenting with a MagSafe style wired cable, so let's check those out. Way back in March of 2016, Apple was granted a patent for some kind of stackable smart connector that can be used to charge multiple devices with one smart magnetic connector. Now, while that is a bit weird, Apple did propose a variety of different connector options, including a design that looks exactly like a lightning port, but with magnets built into it. This particular connector wouldn't really make sense since it wouldn't change much compared to the current lightning port, but at least it shows that Apple was experimenting with magnets. Other than that, Apple also won a patent for an invisible connector port for the iPhone, with some variants even using a self-healing barrier layer, which is definitely weird, but again, it shows that Apple is interested in making a less visible port that could help with further waterproofing the iPhone. The patent even showed that Apple was planning a future version of the iPad smart connector, but with an iPhone in mind, which is awesome. And this next patent is the bombshell. In 2018, Apple was granted a totally mind-blowing patent for multiple styles of smart connectors, showing a very obvious iPhone with flat sides. And remember, this is from 2018, before the iPhone 12. The goal in mind was to make a more robust cable with better protected charging contacts, and the patent allowed for a magnetic connection to exchange both power and data. If you think about it, the iPad Pro Smart Connector is already capable of doing this. If you didn't already know, the new Magic Keyboard case for the iPad Air and the Pro completely powers the keyboard and the trackpad, and it even sends data from the iPad Pro sensors to allow for auto brightness on the backlit keyboard. But the best feature is the pass-through charging port that's built into the Magic Keyboard case's hinge. And the most impressive part is that the charging speed of this method matches the speed of the iPad's main charging port. And all of this happens through those three little contacts on the smart connector. So if Apple implemented something like this for the iPhone, we know that it'll be possible to transfer both data and a lot of charging power. The patent shows an image of the connector, which is pill-shaped and has four electrical metal contacts for data and power. Now remember, this patent was from 2018, so it's definitely possible that Apple could tweak this design to make it a flush connector instead of pill-shaped. Now with all of that said, if you're wondering why Apple would do this, let me explain a number of benefits and new potential features. Apple's waterproofing is already great, even with the current lightning port. But if Apple switched to a flush magnetic charger design, it would be sealed, and it would prevent people from messing up their charging ports by plugging in the lightning cable when it hasn't fully dried. So there's a chance that this new MagSafe connector can allow Apple to make the next iPhone the first phone ever to get IP69 water resistance. And this new connector would even make it less prone to salt water damage, since it's so easy to wipe off and dry compared to the lightning port, which has totally hidden contacts. Another issue with the lightning port is that dust and lint can clog the inside of it and prevent your iPhone from charging. I've seen quite a few people going to the Genius Bar at the Apple Store for this one very simple issue that can be fixed with a toothpick. This new MagSafe connector would completely solve that problem for good, and it would also make charging so much more convenient compared to the current method. And if Apple is planning to pack this same MagSafe charging system into the next MacBooks later this year, you'd be able to use one cable to charge both your Mac and your iPhone, which is even better. Now you might be asking, why not just switch to USB-C, which the MacBook already has? Well, there's a very good reason why Apple has been sticking with Lightning for so many years. If you take a look on Amazon, you'll see a bunch of third-party Lightning cables, And for every single cable, Apple charges the manufacturer a $4 fee. So Apple makes profit, not only on their own Apple-branded cables, but every single Lightning cable out there. There are even some MacBook hubs and docks that come with pass-through Lightning audio ports. For those, Apple can charge two of those $4 fees, so it makes sense why Apple held on to Lightning for so long instead of just switching to USB-C. Now, my theory is that the new MagSafe wired connector will basically become the new Lightning, allowing Apple to continue to charge a licensing fee for companies who want to implement that connector into their own cables and accessories. But in terms of how it's gonna look, I personally hope that it's gonna look just like the smart connector, but maybe with rectangular contacts instead of circular, and being completely flush with the flat bottom of the iPhone, with the metal contacts matching the body color, essentially creating an invisible charging port. So basically, this is a win-win situation for Apple. They'll get rid of Lightning, which everyone is sick and tired of, and they'll replace it with a new revolutionary magnetic connection that will solve a whole bunch of problems. And it's gonna look even more sleek and modern and allow them to continue making profit from licensing fees. And with this new port being magnetic, it's gonna greatly help with the transition of completely getting rid of wired cable charging and switching to exclusive wireless charging in the future. So there you guys go. If you disagree with my theory on how Apple is gonna implement the portless iPhone, go ahead and comment down below and definitely click that circle above to subscribe if you enjoy this video, and definitely check out one of those two videos right over there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.